Welcome to Brilliant Talks, the series that uncovers the innovations and insights that empower people with hearing loss to live brilliantly. In this episode, we'll be talking about all things artificial intelligence in hearing aids. So this is the Brilliant Talks studio. Welcome to two brilliant guests. Erin is joining me and as well, Huma Yun. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Tell me, what does artificial intelligence actually mean?
Let me try to give you in a nutshell. AI, artificial intelligence, it's trying to mimic the behavior of the brain. And to relate to that, imagine, so it's basically meaning it's processing information and giving you some answers. And the way it works is similar when, as a child, you're gathering information, knowledge. Your brain is growing, getting the information, processing it, and then giving you some kind of solution, what to do, or solving a problem in that context. AI is the same thing. It's trying to mimic this. And the experience for us in AI is gathering data, some information that is used and is what is processed, trying to find a pattern. And then once you get the pattern, meaning you have a solution for something.
And how could it help the wearers all around the world?
When you use the Signia Assistant, that means you say, okay, I have a problem in this environment. I would like the speaker to be louder and so on. And then the AI collects this data and provides a solution. Now, if you get a lot of those data from the different users, different environments, then the AI or in the cloud, you have all those information, you put it together, and then you try to find what are the better patterns. What did the people do? Did they first accept the solution? That means, okay, bingo, you have it. Or they said, no, this is not the right solution, give me another one. Once you have all those data, then later on when you retrain, let's say, the whole system, then you probably provide a better, faster solution or optimal solution right away. Mm. So it's a long, it's a process. It's a learning as we learn every day.
How do you see AI working at the moment?
I mean, AI is, nowadays, is the buzzword. Mm. You hear it everywhere. But, I mean, it's going to be there and it's not going to stop. It's always going to evolve. But you should see it as a tool, actually. And because you actually have AI or artificial intelligence even from the past, now even more because we have more capacity, more processing power, or you can see it from the smartphone, is essentially a mini computer and so on. So this technology, we use it essentially to get more personalization mm-hmm. out of the person's, for example, lifestyle. Information that is happening, gathering from it, and providing, one example, providing what is the best features for you or the adaptation of the features for you. Mm-hmm. How much, for example, I give you one example, would be from someone needing a certain amount of noise reduction, but somebody else wants it even more quieter. Mm-hmm. And the via the digital assistant or AI, you can further tune this for that person. Mm.
So, Erin, how do you see AI? Do you see it as a monster, as many people, or as a format helper that Huma Yun is talking about?
Well, you know, he's absolutely right mm. that AI is such a topic of interest right now, and I think it's something that in some sense has a bit of a mystery or a bit of an uncertainty about it. You know, what exactly does that mean? But for the Signia Assistant, it really means help for mm-hmm. people when they need it. And it's sure, Huma Yun can give you a very complicated and technical description of how it's working. But from the wearer's perspective, it's really simple. Mm-hmm. They can just open up their Signia app. There's a very simple chat interface. They can enter some information, make some selections about what kind of situation they're in, what kind of trouble they're having. And then the Signia Assistant does all the work mm-hmm. to provide a little bit of adjustment to their sound. And then the wearer can say, yes, that sounds good, or I don't like that, let's try a different change.
What is important is that the Signia Assistant, you do not record sounds or speech and so on. because this is, of course, you're violating the privacy mm-hmm. of the person. The data that is essentially recorded or gathered is how do you use it? Because what is important, the more you use it, the more you say, okay, I'm having problem with the noise, or I'm having you answering those questions, then the system gets smarter. That means the next time is gonna give you what you need, or actually also right away, but it's gonna know. So then this is the part that the data that is collected, it's something that is not, well, you don't provide your credit card, for example. It's
luckily,
you know. So it's really the minimum data that is needed, but not infringing your privacy. This is what.
So, what's your message today to the viewers who are watching today? What's your important message to those?
Is when you get a new technology, try to inform yourself by any means, by people maybe have the same thing, or by the digital assistant, and use it. Because the more you, as I mentioned, the more you use it, then it becomes really your own. And then you will appreciate it more. You will know all the benefit that you can get, as opposed to if you don't use it, it's like, I don't like it, I put it out there.
Okay, so it's really an assistant to
exactly.
you.
Exactly. It's your personal assistant that's trying to help you.
And Erin, what's the result with this assistant, do you think?
Every time somebody interacts with it and says, yes, this helped me, or no, this solution didn't do what I was looking for, this one worked better instead, that makes the system smarter. It learns from that. And so the next time that wearer interacts with it, they'll benefit from that additional information in there. But also, that benefits everyone else who uses the Signia Assistant as well. So maybe somebody then in Mexico, you know, opens up their Signia Assistant in the app, makes some adjustments with it, likes them, the Signia Assistant learns. Somebody else in China has the same problem, interacts with it. They benefit from what the Signia Assistant learned from all the other people in the world who have had that same problem and have, you know, judged the solutions for it.
Thank you, Human Jung, and thank you, Erin. We will have more guests to keep the conversation going. Thanks for now. Remember to be brilliant.